It is pumpkin carving time. This morning we are showing you some new designs and ways to make your jack-o'-lantern last until Halloween night. Shanna Smith is live at GTCC in Jamestown this morning with more on that. Good morning.
So years ago, all you could find when you went looking for a pumpkin were the big jack-o'-lantern carving pumpkins. Well, now there's a lot of options out there, and really take advantage of the different colors, shapes, varieties, sizes. We've got the staff and students here at the Culinary School at GTCC showing us some of their creations. Yep. You've been using Al Romano, otherwise known as Thor/Soar, this morning. Your sculpting abilities on the front of this.
Yeah, just playing around with this one. This is a nice thick skin one, so I was just making an ugly face, ugly pumpkin, trying to save it. So doing that, and now I'm trying to hollow this one out, and I'll light it up, I'm gonna pop some holes in it, clean it up a little bit, and this will be a lit one.
So the white pumpkins, the green pumpkins, they're gonna be a little bit thicker skin, a little harder
right.
to carve.
Definitely, the white one, the Casper pumpkin, really hard to carve, really thick. These were easier. That was kind of in between versus your regular jack-o'-lantern pumpkins. Mm-hmm. Really easy to carve, but they could go through. It's thin skin.
Yeah. Well, this is another just option you could do. Paint the face on, drill holes, put candy in. Keith Gardner, Chef Keith Gardner worked on that. And you're also just kind of carving into the skin of this one. It'll be preserved for longer since you're not like puncturing all the way through.
Yeah, just carving in the skin using this unique little tool. You can draw through it. And giving a little more hair, and this will last the whole holiday season. So
kind of have fun with it, and then other ways to preserve it. I've heard you can put like oil on the outside or Vaseline.
You can oil it, Vaseline. If you want to draw contrast, you can even use shortening and put some white and rub it right on there.
Cool.
One thing I'd like to say about pumpkins: when you're done with them at the end of the year, is if you cut it. So that a deer can't put its head in, but if you put it in the woods, deer will eat them.
Oh, that's a good thing to do.
They say millions of pumpkins get done every year, but they all get thrown away. This way you can recycle it and let the wildlife eat them.
I love that. Another way to have your pumpkin, if you wanted to go ahead and work on them now, but if you carve them, they're gonna rot. You could paint them or draw on them. All you've been using is a Sharpie. A bottle of Whiteout. And it's this
simple.
Is just creating this hair.
Yes, that's the three-eyed goblin there.
I love it. It looks so good. Mm-hmm. And then Ida Mae, what are you doing down here on the end?
Well, you know, Shrek's cousin over here. I figured he needed a little house to live in.
Oh, I love it.
So I created a little house.
And the green pumpkin. Mm-hmm. That is awesome. These all look so good, and that's the wonderful thing about pumpkins. Now you can get creative, right?
Yes, you can, because you know I'm a creative person. Why, Sean?
All right, we're going to show you how this all finishes up, coming up in just about 30 minutes. Stick around for that.
All right, thanks. Very cool.